Hello, and welcome to this guide on navigating the Gateway app. In this guide, we will walk you through everything you need to know to use the Gateway app. Once you've installed the app, the icon will appear on your device. To complete the installation process, Google permission screens are sent to your device. They will ask your permission to access several services on your device. These services include managing phone calls, taking pictures, accessing your device location, accessing photos and other media, and recording audio. To use all the functions of the Gateway app, please accept the permissions. When prompted, tap on your preferred option. With the Google permission screens completed, you are now ready to enter the Gateway to Digital Inclusion. Welcome! The intro screens seen here are just some of the features the Gateway app offers. Before you move ahead, you will need to register your name and verify your phone number. To register, enter your name and mobile phone number. Tap on Register and then tap Next. To verify your phone number, you will receive a 6-digit code through text message. Copy this code into the app to complete the verification process. The next step is to fill in the required details in the profile and privacy sections. Please note, mandatory details which you must complete to use the app are highlighted on the screen. Tap the date of birth text box for a calendar. Here, you can select the year, month, and day of your birth. If you are a Gateway Association staff member, tap the Select drop-down arrow and select your department from the list. Finally, tap on Read the Terms and Conditions and Agree and Continue to access the Gateway app and its features. Remember, if you have any questions about the terms and conditions, please feel free to reach out to a staff member. This is the personalized welcome screen. Let's take a moment to explore the features seen here. You can tap the letter icon to view all the unread messages. You can tap the channel gallery icon to view all the channels you can access. You can tap the settings/menu icon to view the app settings and information. The welcome screen includes 3 buttons to help you get more information. These include a guide to the app, how to leave a message for staff, how to begin using the app. Now, let's dive into how this works. Tap the Guide to the App button. Here, videos related to the Gateway app are listed. Tap on a selected video to view its details. You can also download and view a video that is saved in the app media gallery. Tap the Leave a Message for Staff button. Our staff list is divided into 2 groups, Gateway staff and partner staff. Tap the Required Staff option to view a list of members. From the list, choose the required staff member. Your info is automatically filled in the name, cell number, and email ID text boxes. Now, choose the type of message you would like to send this staff member. Tap the Begin Using the App button. The screen will navigate to the Channel Gallery screen. The Channel Gallery screen lists different channels accessible to you. These include Guide to the App, Resources, Leave a Message, Community Feedback, The Learning Center, Upload Content, Spotlight, The Gateway YouTube Channel, Meeting Room, Live Chat. Tap the Settings/Menu icon on the top right corner of your screen to view the menu options. Profile. This allows you to add or change your profile picture. Notifications. This allows you to check the app notifications. Unread messages. You can check unread messages that you have received from other users. Bookmark. Click here to view your saved bookmarks. Refresh. This allows you to refresh the screen and see any new changes made in the app. Media gallery. Here, you can view all video downloads. Location. Here, you can set your location. Privacy policy. Use this to view our app's privacy policy. Share. This allows you to share the app link with others to encourage others to join the Gateway to Digital Inclusion. Version. Here, you can see which version of the app you're currently using. At the bottom of the screen, you will find the chat room icon. Tap the icon to view a list of all the chat rooms / chat channels. Tap the Community Feedback channel to send your feedback. You can leave your feedback as text, video, or images. Tap the Provide Feedback button. You have the option to post feedback as anonymous or non-anonymous with your visible profile attached. To post feedback with a visible profile, use the non-anonymous form. Your details will automatically be filled in. Tap the Post Feedback button and the form will be submitted as non-anonymous with your name and information attached. To post feedback anonymously without your name or information attached, use the anonymous form. Tap the Post as Anonymous Feedback option and your profile details will not be displayed. Once you have typed in your feedback in the form of text, video, or image, tap on the Post Feedback button to submit the anonymous form. You can view submitted feedback forms under the Archive tab. And remember, even when you're posting anonymously, please remember to use good internet etiquette. Tap the Resources channel for a list of available resources. When you tap Select a category from the list drop-down, choose the kind of resource you would like to access. The category list includes Financial, Employment, Family Support, Mental Health, General. By tapping the Feedback Form button, you can navigate to the Community Feedback channel, where you can provide any general feedback. Let's say, for example, you select the financial option from the category list. All resources related to the financial category will be listed, as seen here. Tap any of the listed options for more related information. This is the feedback section for the selected resource. If you do not wish to provide feedback about a resource, then please tap the Skip button. Tap on the Learning Center channel to view all the global folders. These include Employment, Family Support, Guides, and Lifestyle. Tap on the required folder to drill down for more detailed information on that topic. The Spotlight channel is a broadcast channel. This is a space to apply your skills, explore, discuss, and share your thoughts. Each month, a different topic will be in the spotlight, and you have the chance to join in. Tap on one of the broadcasts to navigate to the intro screen for the spotlight. By tapping the Next button, a problem statement / concept of the month will be displayed on this screen. If you wish to participate and share your opinions on the spotlight, tap the Participate button. You can choose to respond through a video, image, or document, or can also add a link. This is the Gateway YouTube channel, where all recorded videos and live streams are available. Our YouTube channel works just like any other, so if you're familiar with YouTube, come and watch some of the content. Tap the Meeting Room channel to view all your scheduled meetings. Tap a specific meeting for more information about it. The Live Chat channel is a group chat room where all Gateway Connect app users can chat with everyone else who is online at that time. All users currently online can send documents, images, audio files, video files, and so on in this chat room. To chat privately with another member, tap the Private Chat icon. You will see a list of members. Select the required person and start a private chat. Even though private chats are only visible to the participants, please use good internet etiquette and do not say anything in a private chat that you would not feel comfortable with other people reading. We all have a responsibility to keep each other safe on the Gateway Association app. Take this chat room as a chance to connect with your fellow Gateway app users. Make friends and have fun. The Upload Content channel is used when you want to upload content of your own. Tap on the Type of Content drop-down menu. Content that can be uploaded includes images, audio files, or videos. You can upload your own photos and videos that you've taken yourself, or share photos, videos, and audio files that you have downloaded from other places. The only limit is your creativity. Thank you for taking an interest in our Gateway app. We hope you've enjoyed the tour and have had all your questions answered about how to enjoy the Gateway to Inclusion app. Let us continue on our mission to support the community and empower people with disabilities. Thank you so much.